5:30 on this Friday morning when George Yang, a fifth-year resident, walks in to work.
We're heading over to the resident office on the fourth floor of the hospital. That's where our team gathers every morning to sign out from the overnight resident and get ready for the day. Hey, good morning, guys.
Once the overnight resident updates the group on how each patient is doing,
start with this really sick person next.
The group splits off and visits each patient.
Hey, good morning. It's Dr. Yang with Neurosurgery.
Hey, checking in for Neurosurgery. How are you?
Can you hold both your arms up in the air?
We are heading over to same-day surgery right now, over to see our patient who's going to get surgery later this morning. And then after this, we'll sit down, finish our notes, maybe grab a quick bite to eat, and then go set up the operating room. Hey, good morning, Dr. Snodegaard. How are you, sir?
Good. Big tumor.
It is huge, yeah. This is a big boy tumor.
In the operating room, residents take turns learning from each other, from the attending surgeon, and performing the surgery themselves.
Two main complications are stroke and
in addition to daily rounds and surgeries, residents also take part in a weekly educational seminar, participate in research, assist in clinic, learn in a monthly hands-on training course, and rotate call duties.
What that includes is essentially being available at a level 1 trauma center. I usually don't get a lot of sleep on call.
It's 7 years of what residents describe as worthwhile sacrifice.
This is probably the hardest thing that I've ever done in my life. It's exhausting on a day-to-day basis, but in those moments where you take a step back and think to yourself, it's like, I get to be part of a small handful of people in this world. You get to say, like, I'm going in to do brain surgery. I get to go do spine surgery. I get to call myself a neurosurgeon, and that's awesome.